Okay, let's do this.
Howdy, howdy, my fellow gamers, and welcome to this week's 60-second review! Sorry I took a month off, holidays have gotten crazy, but let's go ahead and tackle the 2016 mythological action thriller, Gods of Egypt. Directed by Alex Proyas, who made The Crow. And starring Gerard Butler, Jeffrey Rush, and Nicolas Coster-Waldau. I'm pretty sure I butchered that name, but he's Jaime Lannister in Game of Thrones. So with a lineup like that, it should be good, right? Right? Well, with a rating of 15% on Rotten Tomatoes and a 5.4 on IMDb, let's throw 60 seconds on the clock, five categories to rate, and see if we agree. And go. Story. Gods are real, and they live amongst the mortals as their rulers. And when a jealous brother throws a coup, all hell unleashes, and a half-assed love story comes into play with some great epic subpar quest. A rough ride start to finish, albeit with a few fun moments in there, will give story a 3. Sound. I don't really remember the sound design in this movie, to be honest, and I watched it last night. No stellar soundtracks, no fantastic combat noise. I think the best thing I remember hearing was a waterfall. Just very underwhelming as a whole. Sound will receive a 4. Cinematography. Directed by CGI, starring CGI, and written by CGI. Holy shit, this movie is just a CGI shit show. The first Eagle Vision pan of ancient Egypt looks so bad. The best CGI went into creating the gods' animal sides, but even that was pretty rough. Granted, they looked pretty cool sometimes. But holy crap, this entire movie was just green screen and CGI. Cinematography will receive a 2. Acting. With powerhouses like Jaime Lannister, Captain Barbossa, and King Leonidas, you'd expect a bit of a saving grace, but to be honest, no. It even seemed like the actors themselves were regretting taking the roles for this film. The best performance was probably from Coster-Waldau, and I did enjoy the run faster, I can't scene, but that's kind of it. Acting will receive a 3.5. Length. The movie clocked in at about 2 hours on the dot, and it feels like it. There were some redeeming moments, but the pacing was just shoddy and off-putting and rough. Length will receive a 4, and time. Final average score for Gods of Egypt is a whopping 3.3, and that, ladies and gentlemen, is our new record for the lowest score from a review yet. Now, Gods of Egypt, honestly, I went into it knowing it was a crappy movie and still had fun with it because of that and my love of ancient Egypt. So it's a movie I would still recommend watching, especially for those people who like to do those terrible movie night type things. But I wanted to just set aside the bias and just analyze it directly. And even though, like, I did enjoy the movie, it was a pretty bad movie. So definitely take that with a grain of salt. But decide for yourself what you think. Let us know if you saw Gods of Egypt down below. Check out the links down below to support the content creation dream. And as always, stay freaky.